Besides immediate interventions the government is making to save the hunger-stricken Karamoja sub-region, the meeting between the Prime Minister Robina Nabbanja and members of parliament from Karamoja centered on finding sustainable measures that can deter recurrence of famine.
We need that we need to provide seeds and seedlings and also technical support. Where possible, we also wanted to find out how we can provide them mechanized tractors, so that they can use tractors to, you know, to plow bigger chunks of land and plant, and we call this issue of hunger history.
Roads can be used once the district side is stable and these irrigation systems are adapted in Karamoja. I even had a design which was made in 1969 for pumping water from Lake Bisina to top of Napak Hills. And then from there, gravitate the entire Karamoja plains up to Kabong. There will be water for irrigation. These are the things we should now fight for as leaders in Karamoja.
Nabbanja called upon Karamoja legislators to team up and have good working relations with the government in a bid to end the disaster. It has been resolved that food distribution in other wanting areas of the country be halted and all food in government stocks be channeled to Karamoja.
Speak now, already the Minister of Disaster has stopped all distributions to other regions. Now all trucks are heading for Karamoja to make sure that we save lives.
The hunger has been majorly blamed on the prevailing insecurity in the region that is destabilizing the region from concentrating on farming. In this meeting, the Minister of Disaster Preparedness and Relief, Hilary Onek, and the State Minister for Karamoja, Agnes Nandutu, pleaded with the Karamoja MPs to support UPDF operations in the region to be able to get on top of their game.
It is because of insecurity that there is now hunger in Karamoja. So what we need to do as leaders is to support the security, to rid Karamoja of the arms, the guns. We support the security to rid Karamoja of arms, and that is how we shall settle and go to the gardens.
That the situation is bad. So the oxen which should have been used for plowing, most of them were stolen. So it's not uniform. So now, if we can get agriculture to help us and mechanize agriculture, they are temporary. Look, there are no much trees there. You put a tractor, it runs. And so let's now put our heads together. I want contribution from our members.
The meeting agreed to have food delivered to sub-county headquarters to mitigate issues that impede effective delivery, like distance and theft of food.
Resolutions that we have come up with will be put into action. One, we are delivering food to the sub-counties. That one is agreeable now. We have agreed, we are giving food. The human rights violations that have been taking place, we are going to have another meeting and talk about them with the concerned ministries. Then transparency. We are living in an era of accountability. My sisters and brothers, we must account to the country.
I want to tell people of Karamoja that the government is trying its best to ensure that the worries that they have in the region will be sorted, because we have discussed a number of many things.
MPs raised issues of the missing link with the Minister of Karamoja Affairs, accusing ministers of isolating MPs in the implementation of government programs.
To be honest with you, we have not been working together with the Karamoja Ministry. They know it. When we got the supplementary budget, immediately after getting the supplementary budget, even after the ideas we actually provided to them, they rushed into purchase of goods. We told them it is not tenable to be able to go into that because the situation is so fragile. But they went ahead.
Like as I was coming from Kumi, one MP was asking me, what is these lies I'm hearing about, Karam? I said, which lies? That the people are dying, they are eating grass and whatever. I told a person, endeavor to reach to Karamoja. Sometimes we feel like crying, but it is so shameful. And now you are bringing issues of joint force to help to eradicate insecurity.
MPs also accused the Minister of Karamoja Affairs for distributing sick goats that have not only died but infected indigenous goats.
The Minister for Karamoja, you brought disease to Karamoja. Let me put it that way. These goats of Mubende that were brought, there was a contractor who was using my compound as a holding ground. Now he mixed these goats with mine, and now I've lost 70% of my goats. Because these ones came sick, they are coughing, they're having flu, they, you know. And there are no drugs even that were given to a company, the beneficiaries, so that if they fall sick, they are treated.
Reports by Fred Kajubi for the news.